Hello, we're back. Acceleration part two. In this one, we're going to do some problems, work out a few more problems, and these are real easy, so this should go pretty fast. So here's what we have, a velocity time graph. That should give it away anytime we have a velocity time graph, velocity over time, and you see that velocity changing, there's going to be accelerations in there. Now, what if I was to ask you the acceleration at 1 second, so this is 1 second right here, right? This is 1 second right here. And so we're looking at what is the acceleration at this point, right? So as you can see with this graph, the acceleration is really, really fast to begin with, and then it levels off. And so this might kind of symbolize a car taking off. It's going to accelerate real fast to begin with, and then it's going to get less and less in its ability to go faster and faster. Now, what about 5 seconds? So at 5 seconds right here, you have very little acceleration, but still you can see that it's positive. So in order to figure out an instantaneous acceleration from a graph like this, what you have to do is you have to basically figure out the slope of the line at that point. Now, to figure out the slope of the line at that particular point, you're going to have to draw a line which is tangent to that point. So if you draw a line tangent to that point, and then you essentially take and you figure out the rise over run of that line, that's going to give you the acceleration at that point from a velocity time graph. And now this one right here, this line, a line tangent to this point is going to be something like that. So I actually have a little bit better drawing right here that I did for you. And so so here's the line. And so what you're going to have to be able to do, and this graph isn't labeled very well, and it's not very close up, so it's hard to tell, you know, what is this starting number and that. And so I've gone ahead and I've put some numbers in here for you that are close, but there'd probably be some argument as to whether or not those are the right answers, but this is the concept. Essentially, if you wanted to figure out the instantaneous acceleration, which is, what is the acceleration at that point? What's the acceleration at that point? And so, why would we do that? Well, that's because the acceleration is non-constant here. It's constantly changing. So, you can't really have an average acceleration. So what you have to do is draw the line tangent. So, of course, acceleration equals the rise over run of a velocity time graph. So we're going to have to figure out the rise of this line tangent to that point, because remember, we wanted to know what was the acceleration at that point at 1 second. I figured out that we were at about 11, and down here we were at about 3. I could put 2.8. And then the time gap that went over here, which is my run, is about 2.4 seconds between those two. And so you divide that out and you get 3.4 meters per second squared. Oh, by the way, the units for acceleration are always going to be meters per second squared. Why? Well, you have velocity, so you're going to have a change in velocity, and velocity is meters over seconds. And this is going to be over time. So meters per seconds over seconds divided by seconds. So so this ends up being meters per second squared. That hopefully helps you to understand why is it meters per second squared, because basically it's meters per second per second. And because we're taking the change of our acceleration over time. So we have that. If we look at the second one, it's a lot less of a slope. Our acceleration is way less. And so I went ahead and tried to calculate the slope of that line right there, picked a couple points, and I got 0.3. And that should make sense because this is a really, really small slope. It is positive nonetheless. It hasn't started slowing down yet, but it is possible, you know, you could have a velocity time graph where it starts to go like that, which means that at these points, your acceleration has become negative. One other problem here we're going to do real quick. Let's say you had a bus moving at 25 meters per second. So I'm going to have to draw a bus. Well, this will be good. I can draw like no other. All right, so these are the windows on the bus. there's the big window in front. And these are the wheels. And this is you. Say hi, Mr. Newton. Hi. Hi. Hi, kids. Okay, so here's what we're doing. This is moving at, let's say, 25 meters per second. 25 meters per second. Okay, and the driver slams on the brakes. Well, what's that gonna cause? That's gonna cause a deceleration or negative acceleration. And let's say that at his initial velocity of 25 meters per second, let's say it takes him a total of 3 seconds to come to a complete stop. Okay, so what is the average acceleration of this bus while it's braking? Well, first of all, you know, we have our average acceleration. We use this little line to symbolize average. So our average acceleration is going to equal our change in velocity over our change in time. It should be pretty simple. What's our final velocity? Well, we came to a stop. So our final velocity is 0 seconds, right? And change in velocity, remember, is velocity final minus velocity initial. So we have 0 seconds is our final velocity minus our initial velocity, which was 25. No, I put seconds right here. This should have been 0 meters per second minus 25 meters per second over a total amount of time, which was 3 seconds. So this should be pretty simple. Subtract this. You got negative 25 divided by 3, and that's going to give you negative 8.3 meters per second squared, right? So we have meters per second squared because that is symbolizing acceleration. It's negative because we stopped it. Now, what if the bus took twice as long to stop? What would that do? Well, simply change this bottom number to 6, right? So that would be 6.0 seconds if it took twice as long. And so that would essentially half the acceleration. So instead of 8.3, we'd be about negative 4.2, give or take, keeping the significant digits at 2. And so that's kind of just a real quick acceleration change thing. All you got to know is what's our change in velocity and what's our change in time. Piece of cake, real easy. And of course, if you're doing this correctly, just your final minus initial and your time, you should pump out whether it's negative or positive anyways. Now do make sure that you include that, because if you don't put negative, this is a vector quantity, you haven't included the direction and therefore haven't defined it properly. And of course, this is braking, this is stopping. It's braking on the bus, and so we've come to a complete stop. We don't even know why it came to a complete stop. Maybe because one of you didn't get on the bus, and here you are running away as fast as you can, and the driver stops for you because he's a kind person, or maybe he just doesn't want to hit you because you wander around in the street. Okay, well, that's about it with that, and hopefully that helps to explain.